The region urged to speak collectively on the troubling subject of de-risking. Details to this story and more in the national report. With the details to the news for Monday, June 24th, I am Leslie Ann Johnson. Grenada's Minister for Tourism and Civil Aviation, Dr. Clarice Modeste Kerwin, says the region needs to continue speaking with a collective voice to stem the adverse effects of de-risking. Addressing the fourth sitting of the OECS Assembly in Antigua recently, Dr. Modeste Kerwin said de-risking poses a serious threat to the development of the region. The subject of de-risking is one that remains a major concern for Caribbean leaders, especially with reports by the World Bank that 89% of Caribbean jurisdictions have lost correspondent banking relationships in the last 5 years. De-risking in the region and the potential loss of correspondent banking relations was one of two motions brought before the House. It was moved by Minister Modeste Kerwin and supported by all.
We are all aware that in our small island developing states within this OECS space, that we depend heavily on tourism. The visitors who come to our shores, our customers, they pay with credit card. The business people who come to our shores, they pay with credit card. And therefore, if we cannot maintain that relationship with our banks, international banks, we are going to have a serious problem. Tourism provides significant employment to the small man on the street, as well as the higher level persons who are educated in management or higher level service within the industry. And therefore, this would impact significantly on each and every citizen within our individual island states, as well as collectively within the region.
Vincentian politician and diplomat Camilo Gonzalves, son of Prime Minister Dr. Ralph Gonzalves, said the loss of correspondent banking relations is the loss of financial viability and is in effect an embargo or economic blockade against a country. He said the Caribbean must recognize the situation for what it is, a clear and present danger that requires collective action by all members of the OECS and CARICOM in defense of their people's rights to exist financially.
You can have all the wealth that you want in country. If you are disconnected from global finance, you're on teeter on the brink of economic crisis. If you can't order medicine, if you can't order food, if you can't order furniture, what happens is that people have to get on planes with little black plastic bags of cash to do business. And our economies collapse if correspondent banking relationships collapse.
Four young people have won top places in the first ever World Skills Grenada competition, which was held recently at the T.A. Marichaux Community College Hospitality Department. The competition showcased the technical competencies of participants between the ages of 17 and 25 in four skills areas. Organized by the Grenada National Training Agency and the Ministry of Education, the competition was held under the theme Showcasing Youth Skills for Employment. Details from Annette Moore.
The competition showcased the technical competencies of participants between the ages of 17 and 25 years old in four skill areas. The persons placing first in these areas were Jason St. Bernard in graphic design technology, Avion Primus in cooking, Indira Noel in fashion design technology, and Makita Francois in beauty therapy. The various participants received certificates of participation, trophies, medals, and an assortment of prizes from various sponsors including Duty Free Caribbean, Laconch Spa, Innovation Grenada, and Arisa Credit Union. At the closing ceremony, the participants in the area of beauty therapy and fashion design showcased their work in the form of a mini runway show. 'Cause it's working, that worth all the worship. You've been in your bag like Birkin. Never had it like this before me. You ain't no girl, better read up on me. You try and get, gotta read up on me. Being stuck up, gonna leave you lonely for the night.
For this final, I choose life as my experience, so blending. Because normally somebody would choose an object or building or something, so I kind of did expect it to win. I did a panel mermaid dress. So I cut out different angles, showing like showcasing the rules of life and a top stitch, different threading. Showcasing that life is not just black and white, it's color. They have to look online from a different angle and things like that. I do want to have my own business and design my clothes and stuff to be sewn for people.
As industry professionals, we think that this initiative put on by the National Training Agency was a dynamic one.
I'm in a rose, you don't roll right. My chain shine brighter than a strobe light. I'm in a rose, you don't roll right. My chain shine brighter than a strobe light. I'm trying to Coco, this don't concern ice. If I mow the bowl, she gon' mow the bike.
I'm just super excited. I mean, I went through competitions, but not like this, and I didn't know what I was expecting. I didn't know how it would have turned out, what I was getting myself into. All I know, I'm going in a competition, and I'm going to give it my all, and look where I am today. I was self-taught, so I would like to take up a course in it in the near future, or as soon as possible. In the future, I would like to become a general cosmetologist. So definitely, I would like to start my own business.
Avian Primus told us about her win in the cooking category.
I didn't quite expect it, but to me, probably what made my work stand out was the soft colors to attract the eater's eyes. Yeah, it was a bit challenging because I slightly have a problem with time, but like, based on how the time went and how I worked throughout it, I can say I did okay. When I get older, I intend to become a professional chef and someday own my own restaurant.
The graphic design students also displayed their creations, and we received feedback from the top competitor.
I was pretty much confident that I would have made first place, but at the same time, I was still having doubts because the competitors, there was a bit challenging. It was very informative. I mean, I learned a lot from the judges. They're very super, they're well engaged in what they're doing. They also coached us throughout the competition. So then for future reference, we know where to build on our weaknesses.
The Minister for Skills Development, Honorable Pamela Moses, was pleased with the outcome of the event.
I stand here again, very proud of what has happened here over the last 2 days. We hope that if we keep working together, keep training you, keep enlightening and empowering you, keep having workshops for you as was recommended here today, that Grenada will definitely be the first island in the OECS to not only take part in World Skills Americas, but to aim for World Skills International, and of course, come back with tremendous medals. We look forward to that.
For the National Report, I'm Annette Moore.
This is the National Report. More news after the break.
Every summer, the Spice Island of Grenada is transformed into the Caribbean's biggest party, Spice Man.
Well, foreigners, come on over. Coming down to Grenada.
Come experience the warmth of our people. Trending theme fats, the revelry, the pageantry, and why we are the Jab Nation. The kids, our future shines on August 3rd in the Children's Carnival Frolic and the Junior Calypso Show. Seven Beauties takes center stage as the Queen of Carnival is crowned on Majestic Thursday, August 8th. The prestigious Soca and Groovy Monarchs are crowned on Carnival Friday night, August 9th. Enjoy the pulsating rhythms of the Still Pan at the Junior and Senior Panorama on Carnival Saturday, August 10th, and Real Steel, August 17th. The Mardi Gras crowns the Calypso Monarch on Carnival Sunday, August 11th. 2 days of frolicking in the Caribbean sun kicks off on Monday morning, August 12th, with the biggest juve in the world. Followed by pageant and Monday night mass. The creativity and splendor of our mass parades on the road Carnival Tuesday, August 13th. Join us in the Jab Nation of Grenada, August 8th to 12th for Spice Mass 2019. Many events, one carnival.
Continuing the news, CPEA transfers will be approved on a needs basis, so says Education Minister the Honorable Emmeline Pair. Parents are given the opportunity immediately after the results are released to complete a transfer form and submit to the ministry for approval. During last Tuesday's post-cabinet briefing, Minister Pair said the issue of transfer is becoming a major concern each year. She advises parents not to become too hopeful that their requests will be approved as schools' accommodation amount is fixed.
I looked at the numbers last night, of students assigned, and I got very concerned about the expectations when it comes to transfers, because already the numbers are extremely high. So if you're talking about transfers, you're talking about additional persons, and I'm talking about transfers to schools that are normally the schools that most persons would be requesting a transfer to. I don't think persons should raise their expectations at all based on the numbers that I'm seeing. It appears that many persons were able to get their first choice, and of course, we can only accommodate a certain number of persons and their guidelines, their policies.
Assistant Testing and Measurement Officer John L. Mitchell says this year the examinations unit had to find placement for 1,799 students, which was not an easy task. He highlighted that the first 300 students were placed based on performance and the others based on the scheme of zoning.
The policy tells us that out of the top 300, each of them, they're placed on merit. So anyone in the top 300, it doesn't matter which part of the island you're from, you get your first place. So that's how we operate. St. Joseph's Convent, they say to us, 90. That's what they say to us, right? And they're right. But top places, 99. So already we have given them more than they can take. So people will come for transfers, but it is our hands are tied.
Mitchell implored upon parents to be patient with the requests for transfer, as the process will be done on a needs basis by a special committee.
A student may, based on the location of the school, the environment, there might be certain elements within the environment that may trigger sickness. With medical report, these are things we have to look at. All right? So there are a number of things. You already might be looking for access. Like, let's say we have someone who is immobile, who is in a wheelchair. There are some schools, like Anglican High School, for example, they can better accommodate such a child, because we may put a child in a particular school that does not have that. So we would have to transfer in such a case. And these are things we communicate with the principals, with the parents. So there are a number of things that are looked at.
And that's the National Report. I'm Leslie Ann Johnson.